Welcome to this video. Till now you have learned about half rotation and 1/4 rotation. Today in this video we will learn about 1/3 and 1/6 rotation. Strange incidents were occurring in King Krishna Dev Rai's kingdom. Though the security was extremely tight, criminals still kept escaping from the prison. The king tried to change the locks, but still the incidents of escaping from the prison did not reduce. The king was worried and called for Tenali Rama, the noble scholar of his court. Tenali Rama checked both the old and new locks. After checking them, he asked the jailer, "Do you open the lock several times a day?"
"Yes, we have to open the prison many times a day."
Tenali Rama smiled and he said something to the jailer. Then he made some markings on the locks and returned to the king. Many months passed by, but there was no report of any escape since then. Then the king asked Tenali Rama,
"What did you do to the locks, Tenali Rama? No prisoner is able to escape these days."
"My lord, I keenly observed both the locks first. The shape of the first lock was such that it looked the same even after 1/3 rotation."
Dear students, let us understand the cleverness of Tenali Rama. Look at this picture. Let us rotate by 1/6. In order to do this, first of all, we will divide this figure into 6 equal parts with the help of 6 lines across the center. You can see that these 6 lines are passing through the center. If you have to do a 1/6 rotation, then rotate this picture in this way. If we have to do 1/3 rotation, then we will divide it into 3 equal parts across the center. Draw the lines in this way. You can see that 3 lines are passing through the center of this picture. Now rotate this picture in this manner and look at this 1/3 rotation. Now let us notice the objects around us with 1/3 and 1/6 rotation. Also, we will see how Tenali Rama helped King Krishnadev Rai and the kingdom use this concept. To close this lock, 1/3 rotation was needed. Then only it used to close. But there was no difference in its shape even after the 1/3 rotation. Due to this, it was not possible to find whether the lock was open or closed. Since this lock has 1/3 rotational symmetry, jailer didn't realize that it was left open, and the prisoner got a chance to run away. When the lock was replaced, the shape of the new lock was like this. 1/6 rotation was needed to close this lock. Because of the 1/6 rotational symmetry in this lock, there would be no difference in its shape even after 1/6 rotation. Due to this, the prisoners got another chance to run away since the lock remained opened. To solve this problem, I painted one side of both the locks. This helped the jailer to identify whether the lock is open or closed.
How does that happen, Tenali Rama?
Look, I am going to show you by rotating this lock. Now it is open. And after rotating in this manner, it is closed.
Yes, Tenali Rama. Now I can see that it has rotated once. I understood your trick. It means that the other lock which opens after 1/6 rotation, looks like this. And after closing, it will look like this. I am proud of your wisdom, Tenali Rama. So, in this video, we have learned about some objects and their shapes which do not change after 1/3 and 1/6 rotation. The shapes and things which look the same even after 1/3 rotation represent 1/3 rotational symmetry, and the shapes which look the same even after 1/6 rotation represent 1/6 rotational symmetry. You also try to find similar objects around you and try to find their rotational symmetry. Thank you.